Yeah, Smart War Games here. Let's check out JTS Modern Campaigns Folder Gap 85. Let me get into my chat. Sound check.
Yeah, Smart War Games here.
Okay, good, yeah. With the recent release of Combat Mission Cold War, we are thinking it is a good idea to showcase suiting operational experience by JTS WDS. Yeah, and thanks for letting me check out this game. I will do it as I usually do it. I will give you an insight of the content of this game, yeah, what force you can expect, what scenarios. And then we will commence a playthrough. I usually play the tutorial scenario, the getting started one, which also coming with getting started PDF. I already have it on a second screen. I just need to get my second notebook online. I forgot that. And yeah, I won't provide the amount of detail I did in those first videos. I'm running a GTS WDS playlist on my channel. If you want to have full detail, where I also give some tutorial on how to use the interface, check out those first videos. And this is about the Folder Gap 85. I already did a video on Korea 85, which is also a hypothetical conflict, Cold War for Korea. And Danube Front is also already on my channel, which is also focusing on Cold War escalation. Yeah, let me give me a second to get my second notebook. Okay, I'm back. And yeah, later we will check out also shooting to for Fire and Rubble Panzer campaigns, which is similar to modern campaigns, but focus on World War II, Kharkov 43. Okay, quickly. So I have those getting started, the getting started documentation. Okay, read the chat. Is there anywhere I can get in contact with you, such as over Discord? Yes. Can I give you my what is the reason you want to get into contact with me? B, I would post you my email. Yeah, I'm curious how Cold War is handled in this game. I think the new Combat Mission is probably the best Cold War game, at least besides NBC Warfare. Yeah, because you mentioned NBC Warfare, that is a good point. NBC Warfare is often excluded of Cold War games because several reasons, but it is part of this game here. He said, remember in Danube Front here, use chemical nuclear weapons. And yeah, we are talking here about the operational scale. Yeah, that is Combat Mission tactical scale. However, you also have, you see what you see now is really one of those huge scenarios. Yeah, you also have the Bundeswehr ready here. Panzergrenadier Battalion with Marders. Yeah, that's basically a German infantry fighting vehicle, similar to Bradley, EMP, and Panzerjägers. Those are not in service anymore, but were back then. And yeah, but first things first, we will exit the game and hit the installation folder, because that contains a lot of information. Yeah, and I'm running, you don't need to use it, yeah. I'm running a window blinds, which helps to get the standard Windows team more eye candy. I usually use, because many people ask, I use Flames by Don5318. And you can do whatever, you can apply some textures here, you can change the colors, whatever is floating your boat. But you don't need to use it, yeah? And I use also a tool called Taskbar Eliminator. I use it for games that don't get rid of the taskbar in order to have more space for the game. Yeah, Control-Alt-T, keep this in mind, because sometimes this tool disappears and you don't know how to get it back. Control-Alt-T, C-A-T, yeah, cat. Bind anti-tank, whatever. Okay, that is the installation folder. Wait, I want to get it a bit. I think that is better. Yes, first, let's check out what you will receive. You install the game. If you buy the game from JTS, the web page is in the description. You will receive your license key, you enter that when you install the game, and then you install it. And it's definitely worth to check out the folder. It comes with a lot of documentation, like this game allows you to change parameters if you're not happy with something for whatever reason, or you want to play it multiplayer. You can change parameters. There's editors for that, like this here. Looks a bit strange because of the Windows theme I'm using. For example, you can change the anti-aircraft strength of a certain faction. This game also comes with a editor for submaps and scenario editor. You can change scenarios. For example, if you're not happy with the time limits or whatever, you can remove them or change them. You can also modify or create new OOBs. As there's many Gentella software games that have already total conversions or whatever, yeah, like the squad battle games. And every of those editors is coming with documentation in order if you want to know how to use them. And yeah, if there's a user manual, it is usually unified for the game series. This is a modern campaigns user manual. It's a bit screwed up because of the Windows team, some tools, some applications don't work correctly with it. And it will also instruct you on how to use game series specific gameplay mechanics. For example, for the Cold War, it would be something like NBC. Yeah, we already used that in, I think in Danube Front, we tried it out. It was a nuclear artillery, yeah. The nuclear warfare in Cold War was not only planned to be used in a strategic sense. There are even experts that believe the strategic aspect wouldn't be that important because of the MAD belief, yeah, because both sides had enough nuclear weapons in order to, yeah, even after an alpha strike. An alpha strike is you surprise somebody and basically pull all your nukes on your enemy. You might still not eliminate their strategic nuclear capability. They might respond and still manage to inflict unbelievable damage on you. And this was enough deterrent for both sides to perhaps not opt in into the strategic nuclear warfare. But there was a belief if a conventional war would have happened, that it might went along for Europe and for other theaters. And that there might be even a use for tactical or yeah, tactical NBC weapons. And this is reflected in this game. Yeah, has nuclear weapon. Individual chemical nuclear weapons, so if you're interested in that, check the manual. It's definitely some interesting. Yeah, in the getting started we will use, or you have it here open. That is, it is not coming with some sort of interactive tutorial. It's a getting started scenario usually supplied with those games in order to help you to get started with those games. And yeah, sometimes those tutorial scenarios are a bit, they can be really challenging, they can be outright impossible. Don't judge by the outcome, but it will teach you how to use systems, how to use gameplay mechanics. That is the most important. Yeah. Okay, next we will check out the involved forces. We have the Americans. Check the units out here. We'll make big pictures because I think that is best. Finding a scenario that has all forces would be rather a time-costly affair, so I will show it you here. And you will get an idea of the OOB and the TOE, the order of battle and the table of equipment. Of what toys you can expect in this war. Yeah, a lot of stuff we already saw in the, here. The Vulcans became the star in our last Cold War playthrough. M60s, M1s, MLRS, Cobras. Austria, is that free Austria? Yeah, it's empty. Canadians. Sometimes the names of the folders not, but this are indeed the Canadian C, Leopard C1. Then we have the Czech. Folders empty. Could be that they're using also TOE or OB of Soviet units or whatever, but can't tell if they're really in the game. East Germany. This, so East German engineers here with NBC equipment, some T-72s. They had some unique modifications to those vehicles. BTR-50, never seen that. So we're looking for assistance and regarding important models in the combat mission. If that is fine with you, yeah, sure. What are you building? What is NBC warfare? NBC stands for nuclear by. Okay, already some Giovanni already explained it. In Germany, it would be ABC, Atomar Biologisch Chemisch, and in Anglo-American languages, NBC. It is basically all those weapons that have an specific effect, and Cold War vehicles, Cold War equipment. Was of course to some extent designed to protect you from that. As this was really a huge threat in this war. Especially of course the nuclear component. Okay, yeah, that is indeed the Polish. Soviets, Spetsnaz, Riding Branivaya, Maschina Picotas, BMP-2s, T-80s, everything your Cold War heart is asking for. Some of those huge arty devices they produced. Air assault, this airborne, using those airdrop compatible BMDs, basically some sort of airborne version of a BMP. Soviet guards, And the Bundeswehr or West German Army. That's some authentic guys. I wonder how they, from where they got those pictures. When they already carry Flecktarn, they still carry Olive. Yeah, it depends. I'm not even sure when Flecktarn was introduced. But that is basically the early, or not early, I mean, very early, it was a bit mixed, but that is basically the early Bundeswehr uniform was Olive. Some sort of an Olive, and then they switched to this Flecktarn, which also had some changes over time. Yeah, and we have our Leopard 1 with attached looks. Leopard 2, Leopard 1, Jagdpanzer with tow, it's not in service anymore. Jagdpanzerkanone, also not in service anymore, that's basically a tank destroyer, that is a 80 German tank destroyer. Gepard, anti-aircraft. Marders, not in service anymore, replaced by Pumas. But some missed it, it was a vehicle, basically similar, yeah, to a BMP, to a Bradley. A carrier with the capability for infantry to provide air guard or close proximity defense by opening hatches. It had a 20 Mike cannon, it had a Milan launcher, 80 GM, similar to a TOW. Jägers, that is basically infantry. Different general jimmies. Good, so far so good. Sometimes you have options for modding or whatever. It could be that there's mods I didn't check out for this map mod. I forgot that. Do that, I think. But I think they're only for Panzer campaigns, right? Yeah, you need to check it out, but yeah, this page here is providing a very popular map mod. Good, next we will head back into the game and check out the scenarios. Yeah, Jagdpanzerkanone, how I like to call it, Cold War Stuck. Yeah, well, I think, is it even in use nowadays, this Striff, this, what was it, Norwegian? No, it is a Finnish one, right? The Finnish. Use, this very flat tank destroyer. Super flat. Striff whatever. Okay, that is a scenario screen. I will go through every one of them. And you can read here below, pause the video. Here is a turn amount. Yeah, you might think, oh, I don't want to play small scale stuff, or I don't want to play those epic. I myself, I'm a fan of smaller scenarios in most games. And yeah, it offers you both. Yeah, it offers you this grand campaign experience, yeah, here 126 turns and move 1 million of counters. But you have also the option of AI assist. When I had my Discord running, there were veteran players. Helway, I think, yeah, who played, for example, he also mentioned he used often AI orders on corps level or core level. I will show you that. Here you see 8 turns. Yeah, pause the video if you want to read something, I will go through it rather fast. Clash of Brothers, I guess, that is already telling me this is West Germany against East Germany. I usually use Bruder gegen Bruder, Clash of Brothers, whatever it usually indicates in Cold War. Europe, Germany usually indicates West Germany is going against East Germany. Frankfurt City, house to house fighting, I want to see that. It's house to house fighting in operational scale. Take us this secret Russian code here. Is this some black... which game was it? Cold War Black... Call of Duty Black Ops? Where you're transmitting some code and then you're being activated and want to assassinate the president. I'd rather not read that. Secret code here. Will activate all stay behind organizations in Europe. The Cold War will return. Stay behind organizations where intelligence assets, either by military or also by, for example, by force like BND, which is basically the Foreign Intelligence Service by the Germans, which were scheduled to, or also some paramilitary or trained paramilitary groups, some also with controversial history, that were trained to stay behind when the Soviets attack, or the Warsaw Pact attacks, in order to cause disruption in the rear, something like modern partisans. Professionally trained, prepared partisans. That's what they call stay-behind organizations. Okay, now we will sort by length. Yeah. For example, the shortest is starting 8 turns, getting started scenario 10 turns. The Battle of at Fulda sounds interesting. That we will play. I already have the file open. I will show it you because I can't show it you on stream. But I just want to check out this house-to-house fighting quickly. But yeah, we can. I can show you, for example, the smallest that would be here. Bad Hersfeld, 8 turns. Yeah, let's pick VP. Yeah, you see a small map. You have always two visions. Yeah, this 3D vision. Some like it. This early ones even look clean. Can also switch between those. You prefer something. Can switch between them. Many play in this view. I also prefer this view. Some zoom levels, but here you don't need them. It is rather small scenario, but you can also campaign for strategies with strategies. Yeah, sometimes you have those. You can make choices. This time we will pick NATO. Yeah, if you like it big. Yeah, we already attacked. I guess the Warsaw Pact is starting first. Let's put fast AI processing on. That could take some time to resolve because this is really... some of those games go really huge. The AI is currently doing, I mean, like sometimes you can do a bit to the map, but the PC is currently heavy processing what the Soviets are doing. Yeah, here the Germans holding this part, this US. That is the AO, very huge. That is really where you can spend months in it, yeah. That is really the huge operation scenarios. However, if you say, yeah, okay, I like it huge, but I can't put, it is too much for me to use every single counter, push it, I can't beat it. Yeah, I will show it you. And it will now take some time for the Soviets to resolve the turn. Because you need to imagine the masses of Panzer campaigns or modern campaigns are basically, I think, simulating on company level, but up to the entire thing. Okay, some helos appearing here. Zoom in. Helos of the identified of the 27th Guards Motor Rifle Division. Sowjetische Heeresflieger. And they landed. I think this means they landed. Yeah, they're deploying some airborne troops there in this town. Wait, and activate that by, what was it, Alt-Shift. Got the order. Yeah, that was the room. Ah, here. Shift-Alt. They're deploying near Göttingen. Turn on divisional markings in order to identify better what is belonging to which division. Yeah, and fight in Göttingen. Okay, that was not too slow. Yeah, there was some minor exchanges in Göttingen, but our Panzer Battalion with Leo once maintained everything. Okay, seems like they're deploying some forces. What I wanted to show you, exactly, yeah, if you want to play this, but you should say, I like it, but deploying every single unit is too much for me. All those operational games here, Koblenz, Wetzlar, Frankfurt. Yeah, Frankfurt is hotspot. And you see those colors, yeah? You pick, for example, HQ element. Let's find something here. HQ 2nd Brigade. Select them, and then you hold Alt. Let's say you want to attack Vogelsberg for some reason. Yeah, zack. All elements that are under command of 2nd Brigade will commence assault. And you might say, yeah, it's too much. I don't want to pull forces out of Bad Nauheim, yeah, then delete them, right? I don't want to pull forces out of Butzbach, delete them. Just Frankfurt and Gelnhausen, push towards Vogelsberg. Sure, I mean, it is still AI, yeah? Don't expect them to pull off some some Wally results. You might need to, especially what in our Discord was mentioned, when they come in close to a target, or close to their designated target, either give a new target, because otherwise they might start to circle jerk around it, or go manual a bit. But on this grand scale, I wouldn't even care that much, yeah? Because in reality, you also can't micromanage the heck out of every single company or battalion. It's even on battalion. Most units are battalion level because of the amount of forces involved. Yeah, battalion level, most forces. But you can sometimes split them, yeah, into companies or whatever. And yeah. I think it is sometimes also fine if the AI, you know, your enemy, if you play multiplayer, sure, it's a different thing. Yeah? You might, I don't know, if you play with something and you go full competitive, of course. Human input is always better. But if you play against AI, the AI is of course also a bit struggling. Using those AI orders, I think, is really convenient. Usually you need to pick the HQ and then give orders. And they will move out, they will try to maintain some formation, they will provide support to their units and yeah, try to pull it off. Yeah, that's the 3D vision again. If you prefer that, you can also use some. Unless you have some. If you prefer prefer graphics instead of NATO counters, sure, you can go for that. Okay. That's for the game, yeah, and the rest, if you want, I often talked about the interface, but repeating myself for every video would be also rather... you usually have the way to do a lot of stuff here or here via that, or via hotkeys. We might be ready to start the getting started scenario. Okay, let's see the. I will show you the documentation quickly for it, so you have an idea. Make it now full screen for. It will show you here how to pick everything. Yeah, we will play NATO against Warsaw Pact on AI. And then it gives you, usually it gives you some information how to, what to do on the first turns, and then they leave you to that. Some of those tutorials are a bit too basic, but the more recent tutorials or game releases of GTS, WDS, usually somewhat more. And then I will follow a bit, but I will also play by my own once I have an idea of what is the intent. Because if you... Okay, let's start the scenario. Yeah, but first I want to check out this Frankfurt thing. That's a nice scenario. Oh, that is a lot of forces. Yeah, that is really some house fighting here. But then I picked the Warsaw. Yeah, I'm the Warsaw Pact here. Tank battalions all over the place. Frankfurt. The clash for Frankfurt. T-72s, BRDM-2s. BMT-2 motorized, mechanized. Facing against the Bundeswehr and the US Army in Frankfurt. Okay, yeah, that looks really like also ausfighting. Okay, let's get started. Yeah, you have some rules. What I really like about this publisher is that you often have the ability, you and your gaming partner have options. Options are always good. And as I mentioned, you can also mod a lot, change values. Nuclear scenario termination. Does this mean if somebody goes nuclear, it's over? Yeah, that's so, because, you know, in warfare there's nothing written in stone. There's a lot of stuff in history, and this of course then also displays in wargaming. That is opinion. Yeah, there's different opinions on that. For example, how good was, I don't know, the visibility of whatever air units, or how good were the reconnaissance capabilities of air units, etc. How strong were low fuel effects, counter battery fire, how good would it be? And nobody can tell, yeah, this one never happened. And even for wars that happened, yeah, you sometimes can't. Yeah, World War II as well, there's a lot of stuff that is debated. People saying, nah, it was green, others saying it is blue. And yeah, always good to have rules. For this stuff you have basically optional rules. We will play by default. NATO, let's go. And we are defending Fulda itself, okay. RT, mine, ammunition available free. Good, I need quickly to attend something. And I'll get something to drink. Need to quickly get a voice message recorded and I will return. Okay, I'm back. Let's read the chat. I'm looking for skins. CMFI. The main issue is importing the helmet. You mean Blender. Only this game had a good AI. I will play this for hours. Depends on the scenario. You might need to check those revisited scenarios in many games. They come with changes, perhaps. Congrats for 3000 subs. Yeah, thanks, Tobias. Months more like years. Danube Fund is even bigger, from Denmark to Austria, from Strasbourg to Berlin. Yeah, that was really huge. It's also on the channel. So, let's see, what is the documentation saying here? Yeah, let's read first the briefing. Town of Fulda, 60 miles east of Frankfurt, 1985. Early morning surprise, Warsaw packed 8 Guards Army advancing quickly towards Fulda, the home of the American 1st Squadron, 11th Armor Cav Regiment, ACR and HQ. The task is simple. The 1st ACR, 11th ACR must delay the VP forces enough for NATO reinforcements to arrive. This will be at least in 24 hours, and maybe longer, depending on the NATO air campaign. The next days will be grim for NATO. I like the briefing. Something more, not only this cold style, this giving you already an impression that something is coming at you. 10 turns, okay. Good, let's see what I quickly will skim over it. But if you new or whatever, you want to do better than me, of course, read it properly. Yeah, we have armor, we have mechanized. We have RT, we have some Abrams M1s, unitless. Yeah, if you click on a tile, you will see the units here. You can deselect, select them by right click. You can get more details about them and hierarchy. You can also get more information on the tile. For example, we know on this red highlighted tile, we have a river here, northwest. 230 is, I think, the defense value of it. River, heavy bridge. Heavy bridge, suitable for armored units. Secondary. Okay. And we are supposed to hold those objectives here. Oh, okay. We have some attack helos, Cobras. Yeah, they're sitting here, currently airborne. But fixed, we are currently not allowed to use them. And you can change them by travel mode here in order to get them airborne. You can also land your helos. That's important, for example, for transport helos in order to get troops out. Or simply because you don't want to keep your helos airborne. You know, they might get shot down or waste resources. No good. Currently they're fixed. We are not allowed to use them. And we have Kiowa Warriors. Where are they? Warriors. That seems to be Bradleys, right? Mixed Abrams Bradley. Yeah, that is a, what is it, a hunter-killer team? Something like that, because Bradleys and Abrams were often used in combination. Kiowa Warriors. Here. Oh, that is Recon. Hueys. Recon Platoon. Here. That seems to be a, exactly, a Kiowa. Reconnaissance Helo. Are they equipped with something? And they have a soft attack, but no hard attack. So I guess that is not the ATGM version of it. It's really a Reconnaissance Helo. Probably equipped with something like a fixed machine gun. And those guys are free, Mike, use them for reconnaissance. Okay, and we could already move some force out in order to establish some forward defense, which will also help us with reconnaissance. Okay, let's get first the helos. Airborne by switching the travel mode. T, travel, or airborne in this case. And you can either click every single tile with control, right click. It is some time since I played JTS games. Let's get this beep on arrow away. Ah, dragon, yeah, exactly. You can click the unit, hold the left mouse button and release it. Okay, there are no airborne. And they should remain here airborne in order to check out if something is there. Then the tutorial advises you to get some of those Bradleys into action. B1-1 ACR B-1. It's this one here. Oh. And those chimneys want to move where? As towards the road. Okay, back up. Yeah, transport mode and get them to keep them in the open. To move in the woods here. They're recommending putting the unit. I mean, recommending is basically teaching you how to move units. Okay, let's do it. And let's get out of transportation mode. Ah, Jimmy, nah, come on, get here. Damn it, now I have not enough movement points for getting out of transportation. Yeah, I hope to. God damn it. Wait, let me quickly restart. Because otherwise those guys might be mounted. I don't like that. Yeah, and because I don't want to follow too much, could be that the tutorial will do better than me, of course. I just want to overfly because I already played many of those GTS games. Alternative fire dialogue. Use normal fire, use chemical weapons. Okay. That is interesting. Can also activate all units by double clicking. Position something here. Mechanized. Charlie. I mean, let's think about what will the enemy will advance from this direction. They want to capture Fulda and they want to capture some of those nodes. We need something here perhaps. It's covering a good area. Give me a LOS check. Got ambush position, some little village here. can't dismount them, we are out of action points. Tanks, I don't want to have them in a town, but we will keep them. Hilo is no option currently. RD is fixed. I think that looks good so far. I don't want to have the tanks. What are the tanks seeing? Not really much. There's even a help for map contours. We'll highlight the map contours, which will help you to spot elevations. I usually use that. Which doesn't mean that you see all of this. Always check the... you can also do it like this. The Hilo is also not observing too much. He still could move it. Oh shit! Okay, okay, I get it. Okay, we spotted, but that is the purpose of a reconnaissance. Of 9 reconnaissance helos. Okay, we spotted a Soviet force. That is a armored, mechanized, mixed force. Currently, it seems like they're all mounted. Up to, yeah, 99 vehicles, but you can predict it as something like platoon to company strength. Not even platoon, yeah, company strength. Those guys might be Italian strength. 2 BMPs, or mechanized, and a tank company. That would make sense. Good, do we want to extract the Jimmy? I guess we won't. Screen them. That's good information. Fired on us, but we suffered no casualties. Can 23 Bradleys hold them up? Or do we want to bring up the armor? The armor is currently not having really the best visuals. We could already... What is with Arty? Let's check the air. Air, we have no air support. We have some howitzers ready. That is those M109s or whatever they are. Can we send them? Ah, they are fixed, yeah. Can't use them right now. Sorry, wondering. The RT is currently not released to us. Okay, we have some formidable force incoming here. Those guys might... What is the LOS of them? Yeah, that is good. That is perfect. I think the position is fine. Even... those guys are fixed, okay. Those guys need to dismount. Tanks, RT, yeah, we are fine. Those reconnaissance helos, I need to save them because we need to expect that the Soviets will, or the Warsaw Pact will move along this road. And those helos sitting there, ducks without any weaponry, will do nothing. We have the information value, I rather want to know what is going on in the south. Okay, that is a good position. We might return to this wood line. Only in the south it looks fine, but I will still keep at least one ACR there in case something happens. But they can't utilize the firepower on the north. This is only an enemy intent coming from this direction. Limited LOS there. Okay, we'll keep the reconnaissance helos like this. Airborne. This will allow us to observe the surroundings. I'm pretty sure those guys will push down this road here towards Fulda. But I still think something will come from the south. Somehow I have the feeling. And those Bradleys will get first in contact with them. And the tanks are also fixed. Yeah, there's currently not more we can move or use. Have you played Command Ops 2? Yeah, that's on my channel. Your combat mission streams have been very helpful, by the way. Yeah, that is... Gavin, that is great to hear. That's what they're supposed to be. I know most people prefer this cut cinematic experience, but I'd rather play. Yeah, you should value the time of those guys, yeah, because I can imagine they spend a lot of time in the video editors, but I'm simply not. I don't want to invest the time in that. And I know sometimes that raw gameplay can perhaps give you some help more if you see somebody doing it basically raw. So great to hear that it is helping you. That is the intent of it. Yeah, and Command Ops 2 you can also find on my channel. Played some episodes. Okay, I think that is fine so far. It's safe. No air support, nothing to attend. Turn. I'm running fast, AI. Oh, that's not what I want. Yeah, I had fast AI on because of the showcase. In order to give you a recap, because things went very... That this fast AI you can use for the bigger scenarios. You can also use F567, I think it is, to fine-tune time. But the Zerats pushed down here. Seems like the Bradleys didn't manage to block off all forces. Not sure if there was some combat. But they pushed forward some BRDMs, which I guess is some reconnaissance force, right in front of the tanks. So we might engage them and blow them up. It is reported to be up to 99 vehicles, but we can expect it is something like a company, a reconnaissance company. Question is if we want to pull this ACR here, this Bradley or mechanized ACR, towards north, or if you want to maintain them as a reserve. First we want to deploy them. Now they're deployed. Helos will help us observing. Let's see. Okay, more Bradleys were released, or another ACR is released. Recon platoon, Hueys released, Cobras released, Arty released. Yeah, I have use for all assets except for those Hueys. Those guys have 35. Yeah, that is definitely not a fighting force, that is really recon. They have some Hueys. Is there anything mentioned in the what you want to do with them? Yeah, we could get them airborne and recon the south. Is that what I will do? That looks good. And those helos should help with observing the... I mean, the position is good. I would like to have eyes. Do I want to switch to these hills here? Yeah, that is close, but we will see if this works out. Okay. Good. Now it is about fighting. We have a chunk of force here coming in with T-55s. So I might call immediately Arty on them. Air assets. Oh, wait. F-16s arrived. Is it night currently or what? No, why night? Recon night. And perhaps they are still equipped for night missions. I didn't have time. Currently it is reported to be midday. What does it mean, night? Could be, or perhaps night capable. Yeah, I could imagine that this means night capable. That is a reconnaissance flight of reconnaissance falcons. It's not really helpful, but we might check out the area with them. And that is F-16s equipped for a bomb mission. Yeah, I already know where I want to hit that. Exactly on this spot. But we might first call in the RT in order to suppress the positions there. Yeah, for example, there's an optional rule, I'm not a fan of this, that you can pick specific elements in order to RT them. That is, I mean, it makes sense because I forgot what one hex is displaying in this game, but it's rather big. So it makes sense that you can fine-tune what you want to hit with your RT. But there's also an optional rule that this is not, that you simply by random hit everything or anything in the hex. I usually play with that. So I don't like this further workload by picking specific units to RT. Also like some randomization. You never know, some surprise. I think the mechanized force is the most important, those tanks. True, if they get hit by direct RT, but those mechanized might be more prone for RT fire right now. Yeah, four men, I guess some vehicle was destroyed or whatever, some guys in the vehicle suffered. Let's fire on a second mechanized whatever, battalion. Okay, not much cost, but my cost. It's not, you know, RT is not only about killing stuff, or warfare is not about killing stuff. Warfare is also about 99% of. Yeah, okay, 99% of ordnance expended is going nowhere, but it's also about pinning, disrupting. This plays a big role in this game. If you see three men, you might think, okay, those guys coming with 200 or whatever. Yeah, three men were observed to be downed or whatever, or reported. But doesn't mean that other forces inside this were not impressed by the RT. Okay, now we will call in RT's airstrike by the F-16s. On the tanks. RT aggro fire, no effect. Whoa, okay, that is a good result. Yeah, the first thing you see is anti-aircraft fire. Yeah, when they saw the F-16s approaching, they might had some anti-aircraft vehicle with them, or, you know, usually even regular forces train in some sort of emergency anti-aircraft fire. Even to this very day, boxed fire or whatever, even with small arms, yeah, even with whatever, your service rifle. But the effectiveness is, of course, rather limited. And those F-16s took out three, I guess, tanks. That is good news. Now those Phantoms, I want to know if there's more coming. Check this area here. And we were... Yeah, surface-to-air missile. Intercepted us. I'm not sure if this intercept means that they were destroyed or scared away, but it is gone. Yeah, enemy, it seems like they have in the rear enemy SAMs, so I saw air missiles and managed to, the recon mission failed. Good, next we will attack this BADM reconnaissance force here with our M1 Abrams. Yeah, one vehicle was destroyed. They're firing back, but with little effect, as to be expected. What the heck is this? There was some RT fire incoming. Sometimes RT can also respond, but it costs fatigue. Fatigue is basically like combat stress, yeah, fatigue itself, everything combined. in this JTS games. It can also be simply shell shock and everything, but currently we're doing good. Fatigue 4 is not too much. Yeah, we managed to destroy two of those BRDMs. Question is if you want to pull those. I think I want to pull, but dismounted, not mounted. Pull them here and attack those BRDMs. Dismounted. Yeah, two vehicles destroyed and they're disrupted. That was, they didn't expect that. And disrupt means basically they are not offensive capable anymore. They are not in a good shape. As in real warfare, units don't blow up to 90% before they say, okay, it's time to go home. Usually, even there, if you read historical accounts or even modern accounts, it can take little to disrupt a unit. Okay, Cobras are so ready. Good, Cobras get airborne. We might keep close to the Bradleys. Let's first hit the Bradley position. Let's see, wait, what is the range? Hard 2. So if we hit the Bradley position, we can hit tanks. Let's try this out. We're receiving some anti-aircraft fire. Lost the vehicle, but some of those pilots not feeling well about what they're doing. But it is war. Let's engage. They are equipped with TOWs, right? Guided, yeah, it is. Yeah, 99% TOWs. Attack. Tanks. No vehicles. We lost one helo. One helo was shot down. I want to pull back. Ah, come on. Commit. Yeah, not much effect with those toes. But it caused some fatigue. Oh, we lost one helo. Did we lose a helo or was a Bradley by accident? Yeah, Bradley was destroyed by. Oh, that's interesting, okay. Yeah, the helos fired. It was a Bradley destroyed. Okay, the helos are fine. Not sure how this happened. Perhaps a ricochet. They fired, perhaps that is not a good idea to keep the helos together with other forces. Yeah, a Bradley was destroyed. Those Bradleys. Are they already coming with such high fatigue? The fatigue is impressive. Could be that from the first battle, because we had fast AI processing on, that they already suffered combat without us noticing. Yeah, I might pull out the helo towards this position, or this even. Because it seems like that if you have helos hovering right over position, perhaps that is not a good idea. Check the LOS. Yeah, let them come, and then that is a good narrow angle to fire those TOWs. And we'll not stress those TOWs out, those Bradleys out too much. Good, all assets committed. Sure, we could. We can do that indeed. Because the reconnaissance mission failed, but we know there are SAMs there. But I need to watch out. Okay, there's more coming. Yeah, those Kiowas need to extract immediately. Let's first see what we found there. What's that? Is that some heavy field gun artillery? Another tank company, I guess, and two more battalions of motorized. Yeah, and that is BTR, not mechanized or whatever. Sometimes those. The terminology is not uniform. But those guys riding BTRs, those guys riding BMPs. Okay, that is good information. Might indeed need to pull out the second ACR. And you, Rome, you see nothing here. Okay, stay here. This will give us enough time. Let's see, you might motorize and move into those woods here. What do we have else? Use this position, but that's too far, I guess. They won't make it. Or we could move into the objective. Might be an idea. To fall back to the objective. Motorize. Because once you have enemy in open terrain on our objective, it is really hard to dislodge them. So blocking them off is important. Okay, two more BRDMs destroyed by the Bradley RCR. And those guys are disrupted. We might even push on them. Could assault them and probably they would disband. But those guys would gain LOS on you, or line of sight, and blow you up. So currently I think our positions are fine. I want to have this limited, because having a big observation also means that the enemy can observe you. If you move out of here, they will start to fire on us. Okay, so far so good. I'm happy with the results, let's turn. Okay, Northern Bradley RCR is attacked. Let's speed up a bit the game with F7, I guess. No, F7 was maximum speed. Okay, now I get it. It must be F7. What the heck? Some super speed again. Must be F5 is slower speed. Okay, whatever. There's, I think, F5 to F8 or whatever, yeah? F5, slower speed, F6, fine-tuned, slower, F7, fine-tuned, faster, F8, fastest or whatever, something like this. We will work it out with time. But the Zords are pushing. Tanks arrived. Mike told them. Oh, tanks pushing out. Okay, now we are back in. No, it is working. Yeah, first Abrams down, but exchanging, also killed an enemy tank, two enemy tanks down, three enemy tanks, RT mine ammunition available free. Ah yeah, exactly, that was something mentioned in the getting started thing. Was it some alt... RT dialogue, unavailable, damn it. Something with right click, then you can choose the ammunition. Check that, where was it? There was something specific, yeah, definitely check the getting started documentation. You can choose the ammunition for RT units. It could be, for example, even nuclear, if the scenario allows it. You can fire nuclear artillery or chemical artillery. Also, I like that this game depicts this stuff, yeah. Some games, oh, I don't know, that is too. Oh. MBC warfare, oh no, people will get uncomfortable, yeah, if this war, war is always uncomfortable, it is horror, doesn't matter. Good. Okay. No arty this time. Let's see, what is with air support? Okay, those recons weren't shot down by the German Luftwaffe. German Luftwaffe reconnaissance returned. And the... Ah, no, that's new assets. Jagdbombergeschwader 35 F4 Phantoms. German Luftwaffe are ready to commence. Yeah, let's see. And we have some reconnaissance. Okay. We might hit this position. Yeah. Want definitely to eliminate as much foot mobiles as possible. Arty is not available, so call in the German Luftwaffe. Men. Yeah, that is devastating. That was not bad. Good, and call in another reconnaissance mission, but watch out for the SAM coverage. Called in here. I want to know if there's even a third wave incoming. But watch out, there's a SAM operating there. And I even now have enemy air units here. Seems like the airspace is now dominated by enemy air units, so again, reconnaissance mission was intercepted. Okay, next. Helos will fire, however they are not in supply anymore. We need to land them in order to receive new ammo. Oh wait, we have even more. Yeah, get those helos airborne. And position them. Give me LOS check. It's here. Yeah, that's a good position. Then hit those tanks. Those tanks are key. Okay. HQ, you can stay here and command, and yeah, you will fire your last toes and then we will land you somewhere in the vicinity of Fulda. Let's see, what is the best target for you? BRDMs? No, I think it's again those BMPs. They are disrupted, don't care for them. Fire on those BMPs. Could be low ammo means they're out of TOWs. Yeah, for some reason I can't fire on them. Perhaps I don't see them, I don't know. So we'll fire on this BTR infantry here. Yeah, they are mounted, they are dismounted. Hit those mounted BTRs. Wow, that was a good impact. Yeah, mounted. They are basically riding mounted on our BTRs. That was devastating, 24. Lost a Bradley in the process. Another 36. Another 32. That was devastating. I think those guys are close to disrupt. They took 100 infantry losses. Good. Let's see what we have us. Yeah. Good that we moved this Bradley's back. Yeah, those helos here, they are ready to attack the tanks. One tank destroyed. Okay. I think NBC warfare brings just a new layer of complexity that developers don't want to deal with it. Yeah, could be true, of course. But I think it is sometimes this a concern of somewhat like, is that, can we sell this game as, yeah, you know, is it family friendly, basically? I think that is often also a concern, yeah. And trying to sell a war game that somewhat detaches you from the reality. But there's a shift in the last decades, there's a shift from that. You see it in all genres, like, I don't know, even in those casual shooters like Call of Duty, Modern Warfare, and us in war games. Away from this, more towards the reality of warfare. But yeah, it could be us, of course. Yeah, sure, it is adding a further layer of complexity, true. Good, next, those tanks here. We might engage them with our Abrams. Firing this. Nobody cares. Let's blow up more T-55s. Oh, damn it. What the heck? These guys, what are they riding? Looks like T-55s. But sure, if they're close and flank fire you. Okay. Can you fire a Bradley tow into them? Yes. This tank force is key. Come on. Okay. Cornelius. But there was a second armored company. Not sure where they are. Might still sit somewhere. I think the reconnaissance told us that there's a second tank company coming up. Okay, I think we used everything. What you can sometimes do if you're not sure, you can activate AI firing. Ah, look at this. Indeed missed some. Yeah, very good. That was important. Tank company is disrupted. Might be not capable to pull off offensive operations anymore. Ah, those recon helos can fire, okay. Yeah, with those fixed machine guns, one Jimmy got hit. Yeah, and lost a helo, okay. Yeah, you see, if it's not... Oh, okay, they disrupted them. Okay, on the other hand, that is a good result. They disrupted a... Could be company, but could be also a battalion. What is going on here in Rhön? There's really nothing coming. Assuming, like, yeah, stay here. Overdo it. Okay, it seems like that is the main intent of the enemy. I was there, 85 Fulda, 80 RP, 111 ACR tanker. Wait, 111? Yeah, that is Yeah, we. It's really nice to see. Yeah, I can't talk because stuff is blowing up. Yeah, those tanks are disrupted. That's a good job. Might even push on them. Yeah, it's nice to see. We see more and more veterans coming here. Always all veterans welcome here. Sure, you could say, oh, this is my volume. So do you know that it's real veterans? You know, there's one interesting thing is, if you was in the military, you gain some 6 cents. That is, if you was in the military, you gain a 6 cents if somebody else was also in the forces. I already hit people that, hey, Jimmy, did you serve? Yes. You served as well? Yes. It is something like, I don't know, telepathy. I also had people on my channel, they claimed they served. I could tell by first second they never served. It was some guy. I was officer. Urban warfare is brutal. I was already knowing this guy is telling some BS. I think simply. Some 14-year-old Chair Force Commando claiming Force Veil or whatever you call it. But yeah, many guys we have here that are legit, and it's always good. Ooh, that was brutal. RT mine ammunition available. Yeah, I would like to use it. Where is it? Okay, how it says back, right click. But how was this? I should have read the tutorial. Right click. Wait, I remember. Check the unit and then you need to press units. There was somewhere optional, you can switch ammo. Here. Okay. But this is the option. Use alternate fire. Ah, okay. Use chemical weapon. Yeah, use everything. No, it's not available. Use alternate fire. I think now, if we call an arty mission, we might be asked what we want to drop. At least I expect it to happen. No assets. And let's see what happened here. Soviets are pushing harder. Yeah, okay. Here are those tanks. We have. Which seems to be, what is this for a system? T-62, T-72, I can't tell. And some T-55s, T-62s. Now that, I think the T-62 is looking similar to the T-55, right? And the T-64 is looking I don't know. However, this looks like a T-72. Let's say there's a T-72 and there's a T-55. As it doesn't play a big role. And they calling in Heinz. Do we want to fight them with our KOs? Cobra, can you minigun those Heinz? I'd rather minigun us, I guess. Yeah, that is a problem. But up to 10, yeah, just enough. More tanks pushing in. There's also to be some sort of T-72 or something in the range of that. Yeah, that will become a problem here. Do we want to fall back to Fulda? This position becomes too hard to maintain. Dismounted, push back into the woods. I think it's time. With those helos and everything. And those tanks coming from the north. That was unexpected. That's becoming too much for this Bradley ACR. They're already running on error. Yeah, fatigue is not concern. It is concerning. It is not maximum, but concerning. Ah, they also have some Abrams attached. Okay, how many? 20. I can't tell how many, but they have. I didn't see that here. That is a combined. Yeah, ACR, as it is mentioned.
Same here. So I can maintain a position if he I mean, they're low on ammo, but they are not out of ammo. Would I have LOS on this tank unit? No, but if they move north. Moving out. Delaying them. I mean, we can delay them. Let them pay the price. For every inch. Here it looks good. Especially the tank company seem to struggle a lot. What the heck is this here? A third tank company. Oh, damn it, man. Tank companies after tank companies appearing here. Yeah, a third tank company appeared. Fresh. Freshman. College freshman. Oh, damn it. Yeah, I need to get quickly something to drink and pray to anti-tank Jesus.
Okay, I'm back. Yeah, we will definitely push the northern flank back. Towards Fulda. Wait, what is the LIS here? Not good. Helos, I might keep there. Maybe south is currently problematic. But line of fire, so now to keep some distance from those tanks. Kopelas. But we have at least some time on the north. I might pull. I want to reload them. They already suffering morale. They're not happy. No time. Into the objective. Yeah, let's try that. Don't mount, dismounted, move back into the woods, let them come. Okay, didn't receive fire, that is good. Yeah, let them come. Reaction fire, and then we will move back to Fulda. We have some time here. South is looking more desperate. First, we have still a Soviet or Warsaw Pact company of tanks. These guys, yeah, they will. They are not currently of our concern. Let's call in air support not available. RT. I want to call RT on this spot. There's massing forces here, because you need to take those mechanized forces serious, especially if they move into open terrain. They might become even a bigger challenge than the tanks. Use nuclear fire, tactical nukes. Why is it? I'm ready. I want to use tactical nukes. Non-persistent chemicals. Nah, use persistent chemicals. Yeah, unfortunately we don't have it. Use artillery mines. Oh. Is that good? Do I want to drop mines there? Right on the top of them? I don't think that makes sense. Use normal fire. On the non-disrupted motorized rifle division, elements of the motorized rifle division. Very effective. Let's try out this mines then. Yeah, perhaps, are there no mines deployed? Yeah, there are mines. But usually they only trigger if you move in or move. I don't think they are that useful. Mines trigger only if you basically move into the tile. They're not adding to some disruption. Okay, now let's focus on this tank company here. I guess it is a company. Those BIDMs not important. Fight
das war's. Ja, good hit. Yeah, some sporadic small arms fire and IFV fire, but nothing of concern. Keep blowing them up. 11 men, I guess that is a single BMP basically. Single BMP blowing up. Okay. You guys have visual on. Yeah, sure. Fighters, reconnaissance, BRDMs. Yeah, okay, they are gone. You did a good job here, but they're back in. I mean, keep them disrupting, keep delaying them. They are still mounted. Can't attack them. How did you do that? Soft 8-1. Ah, perhaps they dismounted and then he attacked them, and then they mounted again. Now it's basically useless because they use some fixed machine guns, low caliber. Yeah, then move out here and reposition because otherwise those BMPs might fire on you. Visual is so limited. I'm gonna use visibility. It's so limited. Whatever, move out into this wood line here. Yeah, visibility got really limited. What is the clock saying? Is it indeed night, or...? Okay... We have this ACR here. Which might fight those tanks. Those guys are disrupted except for the BMP elements here, but we need to get rid of those tanks, or at least disrupt them. Yeah, okay, perfect. Two BMPs destroyed. Yeah, perhaps even three BMPs. Something. This ACR is doing a really nice job. I think we fired everything. I might hit the AI firing. Yeah, we fired everything. Turn. Yeah, this could be the Heinz. We lost visual. It seems like the visibility changed drastically. Ah, now here, 21. Okay, it's indeed getting dark. I wasn't aware of that. Okay. Now here, 20. It is almost night. But I think the night fighting capability at 85 should be better for us than for the Soviets. So it could be that. Enemy helo is attacking, but with little effect. Counter RT. Another BMP. Oh, they are this one now. Could be everything. Boah, fuck man. Okay, so far it looks good. It seems like the I have the expectations that they might want to capture this node here. However, we're holding Fulda, that is important. Sure, if we can prevent them, because the zone of control is happening here. It's not that easy to push through here, but they might manage it. We might. I mean, those scout elements, of course, they can't do wonders. But in order to delay them further, it seems like they are not they are not capable of attacking. I mean, they have a soft attack. It seems like if there's foot mobiles or whatever, that you can attack them. But they have no hard attack. Oh, Jimmy! One man was shot out of the helo. Was that really the best route you could use? Right into the enemy tank company. Okay. Disrupted. Yeah, some of those tank companies recovered. We could pull out this unit, move it in the south. But we, yeah, it seems like they're massing their forces here on. These guys are basically fighting our helos, which is not a good idea, but I'm not aware because of the limited visibility of the night. It's so hard to keep somebody a task for, like. We might keep them around, you never know what is coming here. We might pull out 1-11. Motorize. Let's first check what. Ah, the assets, okay. Yeah, call the AD assets on this. Cobra's just up. Damn it, yeah, this seems like it's not a good idea to operate Cobra's above friendly forces. They got disrupted by this. I hope they will recover next turn. Let's first work with this Cobra's. It's currently because of the bad visibility. There's a battle of fatigue. Yeah, we lost a Cobra. We need to watch out for that. Another Cobra down. To supply them, I guess for supplying you need to land them close somewhere to a. There's a supply thing. So remember, no ammo, no fuel. They're not that efficient if they operate on low ammo. They're only using their main gun, they're out of toast, despite the sound. It is a bad thing that they got disrupted. That is a huge thing. Land your helo here. One 1-11, pull out. Movement through Fulda is taking more time than expected. You pull into the town in order to be better protected from those helos. Another tank company. So. Okay, we managed to blow up two of those T-72s. But the situation is getting dire. We won't attack with them. Perhaps I want to bring this ACR also back. Yeah, safe movement costs us a handy button in order to, if you want to prevent units in travel mode reaching a spot where you can't dismount anymore. That's why I hit it. Those guys are disrupted. I don't care for them. I care for those tanks. But we are not capable of firing. Yeah, the objective is now open. Only the out of command HQ is now protecting it, but I need to bring more force on this. Check the rear for HQ elements. That would be an idea. Soviet, this mustache is maintained. Yeah, that was actually a good idea. Yeah, that is something. Those HQs usually ride in rather soft. They are deployed currently. Perhaps we can hit those. The C2 of them. In order to disrupt their entire operation, that is a good tip here. Use those reconnaissance helos in order to identify HQ elements in the rear. And that's what we did. Either this guy will stay here, command, or he needs to motorize, which usually in reality as well, if you motorize and running around, sure you have a radio, you can use it. But what he is currently doing, he deployed those BTRs. Yeah, you see that this is those command BTRs with those radio equipment. If you motorize or mobile, you always lack C2. That is even true to the modern to nowadays, because you can't maintain a proper Gefechtstand. It's everything nice,
is your staff officers.
Yeah, that was a good idea. That the Hind won't go crazy on them and shoot them down. Yeah, we could might lose this objective here. This disrupted thing here, that was really bad. Seems like if you operate helos above positions, you endanger those units below you. This game. Yeah, they want to go for this objective, and they might do it. Okay, some another tank company disrupted. They're fighting back, that is good. Yeah, tow helos fighting back, fatigue. Come on, stop them. Very 43 men. Very good. That was important. 43. Yes, 20. This move was. This ACR here is doing Medal of Honor job. Air recon, enemy air recon on us, but. Sure. I take it. And seems like they didn't manage to. Some air attack. Air attack. One Abrams destroyed. And some ATGM launch on us. Perhaps a Sukhoi 25. Another vehicle destroyed. Helos disrupted. And those guys here. I love Honor. And I'll see this unit. Okay, they've attacked the objective and they captured it. Suffering casualties and not normal anymore. Core attachments are possible. Any units available, that is important. Okay. Low ammo, low fuel, okay. But you guys resupplied, okay. You will extract, but first get this helo back airborne. I want to recapture. That's currently not possible. Let's see, what do we have? The Bundeswehr, the Luftwaffe arrived. Yeah, Jimmy's drop a bomb right on those guys before they deploy. Get those tanks first, then. The HQ disappear. Check this area. Yeah, follow him. Oh! Arty. No. Can you attack Arty with some?
can. What do I have to? Let's focus on HQ. What? That is an anti-aircraft unit. Yeah, that's. Yeah, that's what happens if you. Yeah, get out of here immediately. Those guys got wasted. 17% left, 6 men, that is, I guess, one helo or something. All other heroes shot down by this ZSU. Didn't work out. Once you can have anti-aircraft assets in the rear. They're indeed often close to the HQ elements. Yeah, currently we are not capable to recapture the objective. Yeah, you definitely dismount. Those guys are broken. This helo can get back airborne. He was a real one. Yeah, once they are in the town, it will be really hard to dislodge them. Now we are in open warfare mode, and this will slow things drastically. They have no foothold. Especially in the darkness, in the middle of the night. This will become brutal. What happens if you assault them with their ACR? It's all disrupted. It's this division or whatever it is. If this is a... What is this? Battalions? Companies, I guess. What is if the ACR simply nicked? I want to test it out. This ACR is quite fresh. They have... Okay, they have absurd amount of fatigue. Fresh, Marcy, I wouldn't call them fresh. Some of those guys are even mounted. What happens if you simply assault the heck out of them? Yeah, it didn't work out. Yeah, we got counter-arted. And can't... The assault was cancelled. Okay, I get it. So we want to go back into the town.
Yeah, in Urban Warfare we also lose some of our technological advantage. Basically almost trading 1-to-1. Meine Güte, so ist dieses Scheiß-Tool. Something is happening here. What the heck is going on? Are they pulling out? Or are they trying to shift the entire attack? Seems like something is happening here. Perhaps they're going in for a nuke. For a tactical nuke. All Soviet forces are pulling out for the tactical nuke on Fulda. Tank forces are they broken? No, they were disrupted. Seems like this are... Oh. Okay, so far, turn 7 of 10. Yeah, it seems like the Soviets changing the approach. Very hard fight. They gained a foothold here. And yeah, nice scenario. Really enjoyed it. But I want, we will continue it another time. Because I want to do another showcase on Kharkov. And perhaps even play some combat mission tonight. And otherwise, it will get too late. So, that was Fulda 85 Modern Campaigns JTS. Check out the link in the description if you want to try for yourself. And in 5 minutes I will return for our World War II friends with Kharkov 43.